Love lives here.
Good morning once again, Riverside. So it's so great to be with you. So before we get started, let us go ahead and focus as we always do right now. And let's start with our focus statement. And I invite you to really feel into the statement, feel the weight behind it, feel the spiritual truth behind it. This is what we focus on here at Riverside Center for Spiritual Living. This is the way that we help to fulfill the vision of a world that works for everyone and all of creation, which is the vision for Centers for Spiritual Living worldwide. So let's say our focus statement together, shall we? We embolden people to live their highest potential through the transformative power of love. Once again, we embolden people to live their highest potential through the transformative power of love. So here at Centers for Spiritual Living Worldwide, we have been working with the theme this year of 2020 Spiritual Vision. And this month, here at Riverside Center for Spiritual Living, we are working with the theme, The Government of Eden, based on the book by the same title by Joel Goldsmith, and it is also the title for today's message. So when we talk about we embolden people to live their highest potential through the transformative power of love, that has never been more true than it is today. That what we are called to do, our spiritual mandate here at Riverside Center for Spiritual Living is to do just that, to embolden people to live their highest potential. That means to empower, to give tools, to inspire, to share truth, to live by example, to teach by example, to empower and embolden people to be able to live their own highest potential. And we do that with through the transformative power of love, meaning that we bring love to everything that we do. We bring love as our natural state of being, as our spiritual state of being, as the totality of our being. We bring love, and we bring love onto the field. We bring the consciousness of love, the power of love, to whatever task lies before us, to whatever work lies before us. And my brothers, my sisters, my siblings, we have a lot of work to do. Yes, today is a day for celebration. Absolutely, it is a day for celebration that we are moving forward, that we have the opportunity to now move forward in clearer ways that are more in alignment with our values here at Centers for Spiritual Living. And what are our values? Our values are our oneness, our unity, our wholeness. It's peace. It is prosperity. It is equity and inclusion. We hold these things as valuable. We hold these things as values, and we lift them up. We raise them up, and we live from these values. We live from the values I shared with you last week. We live from the vision that I shared with you last week, and we allow that vision to pull us forward, and it continues to pull us forward. And so we have much to celebrate today, but I want us to be cautious as to how we celebrate. I want us to, not cautious, I want us to be mindful as to how we celebrate in our celebrations. Mindful that we are not arrogant in our celebrations. Mindful that we are humble in our celebrations. Mindful that this is just the beginning, that there is so much more work for us to do. So we cannot be complacent at this moment, but this moment we see as a turning point, as a beginning point, as a jumping off point, as a launch pad for something greater, for the high idea, the high vision of a world that works for everyone to come closer to fulfillment. And we have our work to do. We have our work cut out for us. When we look at our country today, when we look at our nation today, something that I shared with you earlier this week is what we see is we still see in the world of effect, in the world of our country, we still see a divided country. We still see division. We still see separation. We still see and we acknowledge that 69 million people voted to double down on the status quo of the past 4 years. That 69 million people who cast their vote are still hurting and are still in pain. And so we must, as spiritual beings, as members of Centers for Spiritual Living, we must remember who we truly are. And we must remember the truth of all people, that there is only one. There is only one power. There is only one presence. There is only one life. And so we must remember this. We must remind ourselves and not be tempted to fall into the trappings of seeing our brother, our sister, our sibling as an other, as something or anything or anyone other than who they truly are, which is who we truly are, the power and the presence of God made manifest. That each one of us is the divine made manifest. And so I call upon us to be mindful, to be humble, to bring forth from within us the compassion and the love and the joy and the peace that we have been longing for, that we have been craving, that we have felt has been missing. Because it's never been missing, it is up to us to bring it forth. It is up to us to bring it here and now. It is up to us to live it more fully, more greatly, more powerfully. It is up to us to bring the love. It is up to us to bring the peace. It is up to us to bring the harmony, the oneness, the unity. It is up to us to bring that, to be that. So today, we are talking about the government of Eden. And so what is Eden? Eden is a state of consciousness. Just like heaven is a state of consciousness, hell is a state of consciousness, Eden is a state of consciousness. It is a state of our realization of our oneness with the divine, our oneness as the divine. And so a government of Eden, then, if Eden is a state of consciousness, what governs that state of consciousness? What governs Eden? What governs that is our conscious awareness of our conscious union with and as the divine. And when we wake up every morning and we say, this is the day that spirit has made, and we recognize that spirit is law and spirit is spiritual law, that there is a spiritual law that maintains and sustains the stars in the sky, that maintains and sustains life on the planet, that maintains and sustains each one of us, when we recognize that there is just this one power, this one presence, this one law, and it is a spiritual law, that is the law, that is the government, that is the law that governs the entire universe. The law of harmony, the law of accord, the law of balance, the law of equanimity, the law of love. That is the one law, the spiritual law that governs the entire universe. And anytime that you and I choose to remind ourselves of that, then we come underneath. We come under the law of grace. We come underneath grace. We live by grace and not by law, if you will. We live by grace. We live by the grace of God in the Garden of Eden. We live under the government of Eden itself. However, when you and I forget, however, when you and I buy into that temptation, or not even buy into it, if you and I participate in that universal belief in two powers, that widely held belief in two powers, that there is God and something else, that there is God and another power, that and we believe that, we buy into that, we succumb to the temptation of that, then we begin to see with our eyes out in the world, we begin to see and we begin to believe in powers that have no power. We begin to believe in a government of man, a government of human beings, a government that is not of God. And rather than having dominion, we experience domination. And so President-elect Biden yesterday said in his acceptance speech something that was really profound and really beautiful, or that I found beautiful. And that was that the grim era of demonization must come to an end. The grim era of demonization must come to an end. Now, some folks heard this one way, some folks heard this another way. I want to share with you how I heard it through this lens. The era of demonization has been a long time. It did not just start in these past 4 years. It did not just start in these past 200 years. The era of demonization is any time, or it has been so far back that it is what the era of demonization is an era of separation. It's an era of otherization. It's an era of seeing each other as other, seeing each other as opponents, seeing each other as enemies. And there is no such thing. We are brothers and sisters and siblings. That is who we are. We are the divine made manifest. But we have bought into, we have subscribed to, we have succumbed to that temptation to believe in other, in two powers, in us versus them. So this, and then buying into that, we then fall into the human mind, that human sense of self, where the first law of humanity is self-preservation. And in self-preservation, then we are looking out for ourselves. We are looking out to perpetuate that which supports us, that which supports me the best, not necessarily that which supports all of society the best, not that which supports creation all the best, because it becomes about self-preservation. And so then we demonize each other. We have to make each other wrong. We have to make others wrong. And what we know here at Centers for Spiritual Living is there is another way. And it is another way that Joe Biden was speaking to last night, a way that is unity, a way that is oneness, a way that is wholeness, a way that is a coming together and healing together and working together, because that is the only way this is going to work. If we are expecting a government, whether it be the Biden government or the Trump government or any other government, to bring peace to the world, we have misplaced our faith. No government of man can bring peace to the world. If a government of man could bring peace to the world, we would have already experienced it. We would already be living it. We would already be living in the Garden of Eden, if you will. The only government that can bring peace is the government of Eden. And how do we enter into that? We enter into that by remembering who and whose we are, by remembering that there is only the one power, the one presence, the one infinite eternal, and I am that. I am that I am. You are that. We are that. All of us are that. And so it starts individually. It starts with each and every one of us. It starts in our own consciousness. Every morning when we wake up and we say, today is the day that Spirit has made. Let Spirit govern this day. Let Spirit govern my life. Let Spirit govern my health. Let Spirit govern my finances. Let Spirit govern. And we surrender into the truth. We surrender into the wholeness. We surrender into our faith of the divine, our faith of God. We surrender into that. And then we come under the government of Eden. And as we individually come under the government of Eden and we practice it daily, as we do this, we see our world, we see our lives, we see the life of our community begin to shift. Because love meets love, and love ripples out, and love is contagious. Oneness is contagious. Unity is contagious. And it ripples forth from us. And pretty soon people are like, I want what you have. I want to feel free. I want to experience liberty. I want to experience peace. Tell me more about what it is that you do. Tell me more about your life. Share with me. Something else that Joe Biden said last night at the very end of his speech that really was like, wow, that is great. He said his grandpa used to tell him when he was leaving his grandparents' house, keep the faith, Joey. And his grandmother said, no, Joey, don't keep it. Share it. Share it. And so we here at Centers for Spiritual Living, we here at Riverside Center for Spiritual Living have the opportunity to share what we know, to share in the truth, to share in the abundance, to share in the prosperity, to share in the possibilities, to share in the love, to share in the joy, to share in the peace, to share in the harmony, and share it widely. Share it widely. This is a time for healing. And you and I have been called to do this work. Our faith tradition is rooted in what is called for here and now, for the healing of our nation, for the healing of our planet. Our tradition is rooted in it, is based in it, that God is all there is. Oneness, unity, love. And as we share, as we come from this place, more people then are finding themselves living under the government of Eden, under the government of Spirit, under the government of God. And as more people are living under the government of God, then our government is then governed by people governed by God, governed by Spirit, governed by truth, governed by love. So yes, today is a day to celebrate. And let's get to work. Let's get to work. And invite our brothers and sisters and siblings around the world, around the country, to live with us, to join with us under the government of Eden. Namaste. Peace and blessings. So let us come together in consciousness. I recognize right here and right now that there is just this one power, this one presence, this one infinite, eternal, this one God, this one power. There is no power opposed to it. There is only just this one power. There could be no other, because in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and that which God did not create was never ever created. So I know that all of life, all of creation, everyone and everything in the entire universe and the universe itself is the manifest body of the divine, that there is no separation. There is only the oneness. There is only the wholeness. There is only the unity. And it is this truth that we bring forth. It is this truth that governs the entire universe. It is this truth that is the government of Eden. And I recognize that each one of us is a citizen of this garden, is the citizen of this government. Each one of us is the divine made manifest. Each one of us, through our conscious union with God as God, our conscious awareness of our divine emanation and impartation and manifestation of this love, of this truth, of this oneness, I recognize that that is the truth of who we are. And so that is the truth that we live from. That is the truth that we share. And so I speak my word for this beloved community, Riverside Center for Spiritual Living, and each one present here this day, recognizing that each one of us is this. Each one of us is that. Each one of us is a citizen of the government of Eden itself. And we are being called forth now and forevermore to continue our work, to continue our realization of our oneness, to continue to bring ourselves into alignment, to continue to be aligned with and as the one. Remembering that love is our true nature, that harmony is our true nature, that peace is our true nature, that we are spiritual beings having a spiritual experience on a spiritual plane of existence. There is nothing opposed to it. There is nothing that stands in our way. We simply clear away and let fall away any ideas of separation, any ideas of otherness, any ideas that would hold us back from realizing our freedom, our liberty, our peace that is ours by divine inheritance, that is ours because we remember to remember that we are the one. We enter into that conscious union and we are aware and we share it widely. We live from the overflow. We live by grace, trusting and knowing that we are maintained and sustained always and in all ways. So therefore, there is no lack, there is no limitation, there is nothing that has ever been withheld from us, and there is no power other than God that could ever harm us or touch us. None of these things come nigh our dwelling place. Nothing could defile or defeat. For there is no power other than the one power. And so we know our wholeness. We know our perfection. And this morning we remember Reverend Lee. And we know her wholeness and her perfection this day. We know and trust that the medical care that she is receiving this day is the care of the divine, is the care of divine love. It is spirit moving through the doctors, the nurses, the machines, the technology. It is spirit itself at work. And so we know for Reverend Lee, her wholeness and her perfection. And we know for her family, peace, comfort. And we know that all is truly well. And as we know this for Reverend Lee, we know this for everybody who is experiencing any sense of dis-ease, any form of disorder, that right where they are, the presence of God is, the wholeness of God is. Because we, by right of consciousness, bring it there and make it so. Our conscious union brings God on the field. Our conscious union, our love, our knowledge of wholeness makes it so. And so I speak a word of blessing as well for our nation. Knowing that our nation undergoes a healing, and that each one of us is responsible for this healing. Each one of us, by right of consciousness, brings forth the love that we are, brings forth the peace that we are, brings forth the harmony that we are, brings forth the oneness that we are. And I know that our country is healed. Our country is restored to wholeness. And together we move forward into our greatness, into our greater yet to be. And I bless President-elect Joe Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris, recognizing that this is an historic event. I know that right where they are, the presence of God is. The government of Eden is. That they are governed by the divine, that their government governs by people governed by the divine. And as I know this for them, I also know it for the current president and his administration, and that right where he is, the presence of God is. And is ever available for a reconciliation, for redemption, to come back into the consciousness of wholeness, back into the awareness of the consciousness of wholeness, the consciousness of oneness. And in knowing this, I know that love wins. Love always wins. And so I give thanks for this day. And I release this into the law of the government of Eden. Knowing that it is fulfilled, I let it be. And so it is.
Love.